teaspoon of healthy soil can be like a billion microbes. And in a healthy soil could be like 50,000 species of microbes. Like microbes are the smallest living organisms on planet Earth. But they are the most important ones because they feed the soil, they live in the soil and feed the plant to make a plant strong, that insects and diseases can't affect the plant. And in our gut, the bacteria are the maintainers of our health because they digest the food. And in our skin, bacteria protect our skin. So microbes are the most important organisms on planet Earth. And those microbes have been killed by our chemicals over the last 70 years. And the more species are killed, the more problems we get. So why are the microbes important in the soil? Well, microbes, like 95% of the microbes, are beneficial. They support the plant, they feed the plant, they protect the plant, and the plant feeds them with carbons leaking out through the root system. And there's now scientific evidence that shows that the plant communicates with the microbes in the soil. The plant asks the microbes in the soil for building blocks to make strong cell walls of new growth. Then the microbes make those minerals soluble, deliver them to the plant grows, and then from that extra photosynthesis, the extra carbon, some 30% goes back in the soil to feed those microbes in the soil to keep doing that task. Other species of microbes protect the root system, that pathogens, like soil-borne pathogens that attack the plant, that want to eat the plant, can't reach the plant, can't reach the root. So the plant is completely protected. So the pathogens, which is like 5% of the species, they can't get to the plant because they are protected by the beneficials. So it's a natural system of protection that works so good that the plant is strong, and those strong plants make fruit and veggies and grains that are healthy because they have all the minerals that the plant needs. Everybody now talks about, oh, we need antioxidants. But in our current food, like a metadata analysis in Europe analyzed that like in the organic foods have like 50% more antioxidants than the industrial food that we buy in the shops. When a plant faces adverse conditions with the environment, like very cold or very wet or a drought or attacked by insects or attacked by diseases, then those plants can make chemical compounds to protect itself against those foreign invaders and climate conditions. So the plant remains strong. And science has now proven that those compounds that are made by the plant are antioxidants for us and antioxidants for the grazing animal. So it's all part of the cycle of life in nature that maintains health and strength. So if in our current system, in our current industrialized system, antioxidants are very low in production because the plants, the soil, first of all, is no longer healthy, so there are not that many microbes around, all those different species. So the plants can't ask, if the plant asks for minerals that it needs to make something, then those minerals can't be made soluble because the microbes are not there. So the plant can't make those complex chemical compounds to protect itself against weather conditions, against insects, against diseases. So those plants don't produce fruit and veggies with high antioxidants because they can't be made because they are not available. So it's a whole cycle of life that interacts of support and feeding the system, that everything stays healthy and happy.